And the rest thing, here we are talking about quadrilateral. As you can see over here, two quadrilaterals are given. Here is quadrilateral ABCD and here is quadrilateral PQRS. One new thing you can see over here, that here angle A is equals to angle P. Here is also 105 and here it is also 105. As you can see, angle B and angle Q are same, angle C and angle R, angle D and angle S both are same. So what kind of changes you can see over here? So you can see that here side AD is 2.1 and side PS is 4.2. Here AB is 1.5 and PQ is 3 cm. Here BC is 2.5 and QR is 5 cm. Here DC is 2.4 and here SR is 4.8. So now in this chapter, as you already know, we are talking about similarities of the triangle, not the congruency of the triangle. So as I told you, our first condition should be satisfied that all angles should be same. So first condition is satisfied that all angles from this figure are exactly same to that figure. But here when we are taking a ratio of AD upon PS, that will be equals to 2.1 upon 4.2. So here will be 21 upon 42. When you are reducing it, you are getting answer as 1 upon 2. So now when we are taking ratios of other side, means AB upon PQ, the ratio should be 1 by 2. When we are taking ratio of BC by QR, then the ratio should be 1 by 2. And lastly, when you are taking ratio of CD upon SR, ratio should be 1 upon 2 only. If this condition satisfied, means all side having ratio as the same, let us check if we are taking AB upon it will be 1.5 divide by 3. When you are removing this decimal point, it will become 15 upon 30. When you are reducing, it will become 1 by 2. So here we can see the ratio of this side and this side also 1 by 2. Likewise, you have to check all the ratios of another side like BC upon QR and DC upon SR. If all the ratios are same, then you can say that these two quadrilaterals are similar to each other. So here you can see figure 6.6. In that, as you can see, here is a square AB and this one is a little bit in a form of rectangle. As you can see, all angles are same. All are 90, this one also, these all are 90. Means all angles are same, first condition satisfied. But here when you see and taking the sides, if we are taking ratios of AD by PS. So it will become 3/3. So answer will be 1. Now ratio of all sides should be 1 only, then only they all are same, then only they are similar. But here when we are taking ratio of AB upon PQ, that will be 3/3.5. So from here only you can say that answer is not 1. It means this side is equal, the ratio of these two sides is 1, but for these two sides the ratio is not 1, means these two triangles are not similar. So here we conclude that as our first condition is saying that all angles should be same, that is satisfied, but the ratio of all sides is not same, means this figure is not similar. Now here we are moving, you can see that figure 6.7, as you can see, taking sides, if you are taking ratio of AD upon PS, that will be equals to 2.1/4.2. So it will be 1/2 only. When you are taking ratio of this, again you can see the answer will be same, because the measurement is same, as you can see over here. But the different thing you can see that angles are not same. Why? Because here angle is 90 degree and this is looking like a rhombus, so angle will be different. So we conclude that our first condition, angles are not same, though the side and the ratio is same, angles are not same, so these two are not similar. So now here we are beginning our exercise 6.1. In that they told us that question 1, fill in the blanks using the correct word given in a bracket. So first they told us all circles are, so we will write this similar. So for the first question, first fill in the blanks, answer is similar. Here for the second blank, all squares are, so we will write similar. All blank triangles are similar, so we will write equilateral. So our answer will be equilateral. Fill in the blanks. Number 4, two polygons of the same number of sides are, if their corresponding angles are, so here are two options. So in a first blank we will write their corresponding angles are equal. So this one will be first, and their corresponding sides are in proportion. That is the main important condition which we have seen in our last video. Here is question number 2. What it says? Give two different example of a pair of similar figures. So you can draw figure 6.5 for this. And non-similar figure, so you can describe this too. You can draw this figure. And if you want to give more example, you can say similar figures means 2 20 rupee notes. That will be similar figure. And for non-similar figure, you can give example 5 rupee coin and a 10 rupee coin. They both are circles, but one is smaller one and one is larger one. So you can say that they two are non-similar figures. Now here moving towards question number 3. state whether the following quadrilaterals are similar or not. First, we will check the angle because our first condition is angle should be same. All angles should be same. Means angle P should be same to A and Q should be same to B. But here as we can see, one is a rhombus, this one, and here is square. So as we can see over here, this is not similar to this figure. So these are not similar figures. So here we are ending our exercise.